The Home Secretary's ban on the Sinn Féin men took even Ken Livingstone by surprise. Overnight, he went into hiding while he took soundings from his political allies and decided what to do next. But once he emerged and gave his first television interview to Thames News, his position was clear. He would go to Ulster, and he regretted none of the events of the past few days.
One always regrets what happens with the popular press, but there's nothing you can do with it. You have to live with that. When is there ever a time when I'm not being criticised by someone and there isn't someone talking about a censure motion? I mean, what is important, I think, is that we should try and see that we don't have a continuing ban on discussion. I would hope that if the government's not allowed to let us discuss with people from Northern Ireland, they would start discussing themselves. Otherwise, we'll be sitting here in 13 years' time discussing the latest bomb outrage when presumably another 2,000 or 3,000 people would have been killed.
But wasn't it always inevitable that this visit would never take place?
No, I think the government, I think Mr Whitelaw has given Sinn Féin the biggest propaganda boost of the last 10 years. I think it's been totally mishandled.
Labour moderate Tony Judge said the odium of recent events would stick with the GLC for a very long time. Other Labour members pledged to challenge Mr Livingstone's decision. GLC Tory leader Richard Brew accused Ken Livingstone of cynical political manipulation. He called on Labour councillors, honest with themselves and not blinded by doctrinal faith, to hound him out of office.
He's going there with absolutely preconceived ideas. The people he's going to talk to have got preconceived ideas. The only thing they want is for the British to get out of Northern Ireland altogether. By going over there, he's not actually going to learn from all sides of the argument over there at all. A complete waste of time. He should be here in England looking after the GLC.
County Hall won't be hosting the Sinn Féin men next week, but the council meeting taking place on the day they were due to visit still promises to be a heated affair. Barbara Long at County Hall for Thames News.